Hello everyone, my name is Mary Ann Cohen and welcome to Curated by MAC. I've been an art dealer for 30 plus years and I own MAC art galleries. Occasionally we open the gallery and invite in local artists so we can see their work and I can give them some critique and some guidance to help them in their careers. Today we're going to meet Gregory Dirr. Hello, how are you?
Hi, I'm doing well, how are you doing?
So tell me a little bit about you, first of all. How long have you been an artist?
I've always done art, even since I was a little kid.
So now, currently, you're a working artist, or?
Yes. Okay. I'll get commissions, and then I'll meet clients that'll hire me on a regular basis or a non-regular basis. And then I do things like what I'm sure your gallery assistants do, where I help curate and hang and pack
right,
I do design work as well, and you know, just the
so
things you have to do.
So you've got a lot of different things going on. You're
yes.
wearing a few different hats, but they're all in the creative world. So now I'm looking at the body of work. It is kind of all over the place. So tell me which of these is closest to what you really feel is the soul of what you do.
Something along this lines is a little bit more of where I'm going. How there's this flashing of imagery and how it's a little bit more ambiguous. There's something about that that calls me to it more than I would say something like this. It's still conceptual, but it's a landscape painting. It's not as invented as something like that, or let's say something like this.
You've picked up on the two paintings that I see more aligned. I mean, this painting and this painting, to me, are more original.
I will say this, that paintings like that is easier than painting something like this. Like, this is a very arduous task.
The problem with this kind of painting is that, you know, there's always going to be someone who can paint these clouds better, and they don't say as much about you as these two do. So tell me a little bit about what you're saying here.
Everything that I make is very closely connected to a narrative that I've been making. It's about a fantastical world, like Oz or Wonderland, but it's a little bit more esoteric, like the gray areas of morality and existence. It's like, what do the knotworks represent? They're like a visual symbol for a part of the story. Also, I'm really interested, you might see it, but the overlapping and underlapping of layers, and like quilting kind of, I don't know why, but my brain always wants to do that,
well,
and it would be
too your
drawn.
Iconography.
I mean,
it's part of your vocabulary that you're using. And that may be the thing that sort of unites the pieces. Now, developing it and building on it and making it a very dynamic style, that is something that you have to paint your way through. And you got to paint like a lot of bad paintings, frankly, before you get to the good stuff. I mean, I think it's very successful, and I think you have a very well-developed sense of who you are. So
it's
been a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for coming. So, Greg, how was it?
I liked it.
Were you nervous at all this morning, like coming over here?
You know, I was excited because I told her on the way here I haven't had a real legit critique that wasn't like, oh, I love your work, since college, honestly. I like to hear what I'm not doing with these ones that I am doing with this one, because people may look at that as discouraging, but I like it because then it means that I'm kind of on a right track. Like, it shows that I'm getting there.